travel is related to your business. So it is very tough to convince IRS. I'm a local real estate broker, and I fly to Shanghai and talk about something not even related to my business. And the flight ticket, I just went to Shanghai, visited my parents, and know any business related. You cannot. It's very, very difficult to convince
IRS. Maybe you can say you want to get an investor from China.
Yes, if you can prove that you have the investor in there, overseas, no problem. So go back to Mr. Fu's questions. Any limit, usually there's no limit. But ordinary, necessary, they are the major wall. And you only earn, say, $1,000 this year. Again, you report $50,000. I think IRS may not. I don't know. This is art. It's not size.
Question about the mill.
Yes.
I heard some people putting under the marketing expense. For example, I bought a expensive lunch, but I have a, say, lunch top and pay for the meal, but actually it's become a marketing expense, so I don't have to put in the mill, or I need to put in the marketing.
You should put it under the mill, because the reason why is under the mill, only 50% can be deducted. So if people want to put the meal expenses under the marketing, the only purpose is they want to deduct 100%. But legally speaking, they should put any lunch, dinner, entertainment, even the entertainment, under this category. Okay. Meal is the only item up to 50%. Traveling is 100%. If your expenses qualify as a business traveling, it's 100% you deduct. But for meal, I don't know, because you eat yourself, you cannot. The portion, you add, you can do that. I don't know this joke, okay. So there's only one item, subject to 50%. But again, no limit.
The meal during the travel time, is that meal or travel?
Very good questions. Okay, let me repeat her questions, okay?
Let me repeat her questions.
Very good questions, okay? Let me define. You have a business travel to Shanghai, and you can prove this traveling really related to your business, no doubt. However, this is a 5 days back and forth, right? So during the traveling, you add something, right?
Mm-hmm.
Can you deduct it?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Go back. No, it's not you think so, okay? There's a rule, okay? You need to relate each meal, whether or not, to business.
And then 50%.
You got it? So, on the airplane, no. And at the airport, you just add something by yourself without any business talk? Of course not, cannot. Okay. But again, there is a very complex rule, okay? For the meal expenses. Again, if you can prove your meal related to business, no any problem, you deduct 50%. But go back to her questions. The meal by itself does not relate to business, but only cover your traveling. There is the rule. Okay, so you want to pick up that topic, this is a good topic. Yeah.
No
answer. We need to go back to the rule.
Can you elaborate this a little bit more? Say, for example, I have a meeting in Taipei on Tuesday. Why would I travel on Monday? I had to eat. Right?
Yes.
So that's...
Yes, some questions. Yeah.
Some meal I had to...
So let me give you that kind of... It is deductible, but there's a rule. There's a rule. This is called per diem rule. Per diem means there's a limit per day. Understand? It makes sense. Otherwise, I just spend money to the very luxury hotel. Yeah. Right? So the answer is yes. Again, if the meal related to your business, no any question already, you deduct 50%. However, the meal by itself does not relate directly to business. However, this meal cover your traveling, yes, it's deductible, but there's a limit. It's called per diem or per day limit. The limit was the maximum amount you can deduct for the meal on the road, on the way.
Yeah, how about the ticket, such as I bought
a flight ticket is no problem.
No problem.
What kind of ticket? Baseball ticket or?
Baseball ticket for the clients?
No, I didn't miss it.
Baseball ticket.
Oh, okay. His question is how about the ball game? Right? Wow, it's very expensive. Right? Last year, Giants, the final World Series, it's $10,000.
$10,000.
We have one example in our book. Okay? If you spend $10,000 each ticket, can you claim that? The answer is no. Because for IRS purposes, number one, you must relate this to a business. So during the ball game, you must go for business. That's very strange, okay? Your eyes watch ball game and your mouth go for business. It's very, very strange. However, that's number one requirement. Number two, you can only deduct the face value. Doesn't matter how much money you spend. They say the face value is only $200. Okay, you can only maximum.
Go up to $10,000?
No, you're paying $10. Yeah, of course. Some people are crazy, you know. I'm not that crazy. But anyway, some people spend, you know, $10,000 just for one.
$25.
Anyway, we're gonna see that, okay? So the answer to your questions, yes, if your ticket relate to business and only up to the face value. Okay. Eventually I believe that's your homework for the day. I think so. 25, utility. Big thing right now, everybody use cell phone, right? Cell phone become your business expense.
Excuse me.
And few people use a regular phone. Yes.
Back to 24 entertainment, is that 100% deductible?
No, this is subject to 50%. Everything under the small letter B, mail and entertainment. Don't forget, you must relate it to your business, and it must be. Necessary, must be ordinary, and then 50%. And for the entertainment, only up to your ticket face value. Doesn't matter how much you spend. Utility, so internet, for example, right? You spend internet, anything, PG&E, anything here, utility. So maybe the one big item, maybe. By rule, okay, very strange rule. That rule, I think, is out of date already. If you use the regular ground line telephone, the first line you cannot deduct. And the second line you can deduct. But nothing mentioned about the cell phone. No any regulation about it. So I believe, you know, your cell phone, as long as your proof is for your business, you can deduct it. 26, wages. Wages. So it's very strange. If your individual business, you pay regular salary to your employee. It's strange, but it happens. Okay, you are running your personal business. It is not corporation, your own business. You still pay salary, even to yourself, maybe, to your family member. Because the purpose probably to accumulate social security. We talked about that issue right the other day. So you deduct it. 27 is a big issue, other expenses. For example, dress. We don't forget that the lady asked me, can I deduct? You know, she spent $2,000 last year for dress, for dresses, for shoes, you know, very high-end shoes, you know. So the answer is yes or no. You need to justify and to prove whether or not this expense is ordinary and necessary for your business. Yes?
For example, if I can movie ticket, just I basically pass it to the secretary in order for me to line up the meeting. Can I expense that? Or? No.
It may become employee benefit.
But that's a customer secretary or some can I give it to customer passing out?
Probably not, but maybe qualify as a marketing expense. You know, marketing, if each gift is under $25, very small amount. Okay. So example, I have the pens, a giveaway. I order 1,000 pens like this, and with my name and phone number, and I just give away to anybody, potential client at a show, at Escape. I just give away. And for each one, as long as it's under $25. By law, you cannot spend more than $25 one year to one person. But you give away, you never know who you give to. So as long as this gift is under $25, so 25 times, say, 1,000, you can all report it as marketing expenses. So probably not qualify as entertainment, but qualify as another.
What is the marketing expense?
Yeah, this is under 27. So there's no There's no really the item called marketing expenses, but it's under 27. You can say this marketing.
So if I, you know, I meet with my client, every time I pick up some gift for them, you know, different kind of gift. So I can just put it under the 27.
But be careful. Yes, under 27. But be careful. Each person per year only limit under $25.
One person, only
$25. Yeah, 1 person, 1 year, $25.
So if the thing I give it to her is $100.
You cannot report it. You can give whatever you want. It's a business.
I cannot claim that as my business expense.
No, cannot.
This is pure for business relationship.
Again, uh-huh. Again, yes, of course.
So can I put in another category?
Very tough, very difficult. I could, well, this is a good example. This is a good, very good study topic, right? Her situation is, I just, one of my regular clients, very important one. So every month I have the red wine. Every month I give a red wine, so accumulate for whole year. I spend $1,000. But this is a gift, right? Don't forget, this is a gift. Gift means I just give away, right? So for business gift, 1 person, 1 year, you can only report $25. I just cannot figure out any other item I can put into. It is not office expense, right? Very difficult to qualify this as a office or qualify as a surprise. It's not surprise. Surprise means paper, toner, this is, you know. But this kind, this really bothered me. That's really bothered me. You know, for any kind of service business, we always try to keep the PR, right? Public relationship with our client. So we always figure out to, you know, to present some gift to them. The problem is, how can I deduct?
$25
is so little. $25. So you just buy $5 wine. Anyway. Good questions, good topic.
You know. So the $25 per person, is there a limit how many persons?
So no, there's no limit.
So, okay. So
if you have 10,000 people, there's 25 by 10,000.
Okay, so yeah. If IRS in case audit, so I need to keep track.
Yes, yes, mm-hmm. Yes, yes. Very tedious, very, very tedious. Any question?
If you are a US company, you send someone to, say, abroad or whatever, any other